Oasis Audio presents All is Calm by Colleen Coble, read for you by Pam Turlow. Chapter 1. This is wrong on every count. Christmas was 3 weeks away. Did that mean nothing to these men? Lauren Everman darted into the barn and locked the padlock from the inside. Angel, the black stallion behind her, snorted when she rattled the chain to make sure it held.
"Lauren, you unlock this door right now!"
Ranch owner Charles McLeod yelled from outside the barn.
"You know it has to be done!"
It wasn't his fault! She backed away from the door and went to stand near Angel's stall. "It's okay, boy. I won't let anyone hurt you."
"The vet can't stay any longer. We can do this nice and humane, or I'll just have to shoot him later."
Her boss pounded on the door. "I'm telling you, it wasn't his fault! Someone shot him full of some kind of drug. I saw it." She had no real hope McLeod would listen to her. Trouble always seemed to find her no matter what she did or how hard she tried. She'd already tried to tell him about the shadowy figure she'd seen 2 days ago and the bullet that had come whizzing by her head. He claimed she was being dramatic and just wanted attention. She knew better. Angel would never hurt anyone on purpose. As if to contradict her, the stallion bit down on her arm hard enough to make her wince. She jerked out of his way. Poor fellow. Angel was stressed. She moved down the length of the stall and checked the back door to make sure it was securely locked. It was. So were the windows. No one was getting in here unless she let them. McLeod shouted her name again, then peered through the window at her. She turned her back on him and flopped down in the hay. Might as well make herself comfortable. It was going to be a long night. Through one window, the sunset put on a spectacular show. She focused on it and tried to tune out the angry men outside. They couldn't kill Angel. They just couldn't. She'd never be able to live with the injustice of it. An idea began to foment. What if she escaped with him and went far away where they'd never find him? With Tanya's lies, the police had been questioning her about Dustin's death as if she was a suspect. But where could she go to find a safe haven? Bluebird Ranch. The notion popped into her head. She'd spent a life-changing summer there 12 years ago when she was 17. It was a terrific ranch that paired abused children with abused horses. When she was a foster kid, the place had been the one bright spot for her. There was always a place there for a good horse and a hard worker. She could get there in a day. All she had to do was get to El Paso, then head east to the Big Bend area of West Texas. She got up and dusted the hay off her jeans. She couldn't just steal the horse, though. The horse was worth 10 grand. On second thought, if McLeod was prepared to put him down anyway, any money he got should make him happy. Her heart singing, she practically ran to her room, a tiny space in the back of the barn, and dug out her checkbook. She wrote out a check for $5,000, nearly cleaning out her account, and tucked the corner of the check under a lamp on the nightstand. Once they left her in peace, she'd make her getaway under cover of night. She grabbed her Stetson. It wouldn't be the first time she'd run. Brendan Waddell had always considered the Bluebird Ranch a little piece of heaven, and today was no exception when he parked his truck in the dirt drive and got out. He drew in a deep breath of mesquite and creosote, the finest scent on earth as far as he was concerned. The twinkling Christmas lights welcomed him. Allie Bailey, Rick's petite wife, bounced down the porch steps before he even managed to shut the door behind him. "You're late." Her tight hug told him he was welcome.
Had to stop for gas.
And to walk off the pain gripping his right leg. But he wasn't about to tell her that. He released her and stepped back, eyeing the huge tummy bulge under her sleeveless red top.
"You look like you're about to pop."
Her bright blue eyes widened.
"How ungentlemanly of you to notice."
Her laugh rang out.
"It's a girl this time. Due end of December."
"I bet Rick is over the moon."
"Sure is. We both want a big family."
He followed her toward the house, a sprawling home typical of its West Texas setting. White barns, outbuildings, and bunkhouses ranged over the property. This place was exactly what he needed. A young woman pushing a child in a tire swing under a large mesquite tree caught his attention. He'd seen her before somewhere, hadn't he? Or a picture of her, maybe. In his intelligence position with Special Ops, he read every bit of local news and unusual circumstances that came across his desk. She didn't seem to notice him staring as she pushed the little girl higher and higher. He nodded toward the two.
Who's that?
Interested? I think she's single.
Allie's impudent grin flashed up at him. Used to friends trying to marry him off, Brendan kept his face impassive. If he ignored the innuendos, they'd leave him alone sooner or later.
She just looks familiar. Was she here last time I came?
Allie shook her head as she mounted the steps to the house.
Lauren just arrived a couple of days ago looking for a job. She was a guest here years ago when she was a teenager. As luck would have it, we were in need of a new horse trainer. She's amazing with horses. It's like she speaks their language.
Her letters of recommendation were impeccable, and Rick hired her on the spot. He spared one last glance at the brunette. The ponytail holding her dark hair emphasized her high cheekbones and expressive dark brown eyes. She looked over and caught his gaze. A tinge of color sprang to her face, and she turned away to attend to the little girl.
Her kid?
No, one of our foster kids here for the summer.
Allie opened the screen door.
Rick will be home in a few minutes. He ran to the feed store.
When Brendan entered the living room, a whirlwind attacked his good leg. He lifted the 4-year-old into his arms, and little Matthew clung like a monkey.
Hey, Squirt.
The little boy puffed out his chest.
I'm not a squirt anymore, Uncle Brendan. I'm big.
You've grown 2 inches since I saw you.
Brendan set him back on the floor and lifted a brow in Allie's direction.
My usual room?
It's all ready for you.
I'll be right back.
He sniffed the air, redolent with the aroma of Mexican spices.
Smells like enchiladas.
His stomach rumbled. Allie smiled and took her son's hand.
You nailed it.
Brendan went down the hall and dropped his luggage, then headed for the kitchen. Allie nodded out the window.
Rick just got back. Have a seat and we'll eat.
I'm starved.
He pulled out a chair beside Matthew. The front door banged, and he rose to greet Rick. The two had been in the Marines together before Rick got out and came home to West Texas. Brendan had gone on to bigger and better things with the intelligence division, or so he'd thought at the time. Now, looking at the happy family around him, Brendan wasn't so sure what he should decide this time. He could take a medical discharge or fight it and end up pushing papers the rest of his military career. Rick hadn't changed much in the 10 years they'd been friends. There was a few more lines around his blue eyes, but his rangy form was just as lean and muscular as ever. As Brendan shook Rick's hand, he noticed another figure behind him. Lauren, the woman from the front yard. Their gazes locked for a moment, then she ducked her head and went to pull out the chair at the other end of the table. Rick glanced her way.
Lauren, he's not as surly as he seems. Smile, Brendan. I know you know how.
Brendan blinked, then managed a grin.
I promise not to bite.
Lauren's gaze came up, and a tiny smile lifted her lips. She was really a knockout up close. Perfect olive skin, and eyes fringed with thick lashes.
Where are you from, Lauren?
He put the question out with practiced charm. She bit her lip and looked down at her plate.
Dallas area.
What was she hiding? He could sniff out deception a mile away.
You don't have much of a Texas accent.
Originally from Indiana. I've just been in Dallas 3 years.
You're a horse trainer?
Her nod came, barely discernible.
I love horses.
Rick pulled out a chair beside his son.
She brought a stallion with her. We've already had a neighbor ask to use him as a stud. He's gorgeous.
A genuine smile brightened Lauren's face.
I fell in love with him the first time I saw him.
Everyone was afraid of him, but he's a sweetheart.
Allie unfolded her napkin.
I don't know about that. He won't let me within 5 feet of him. You've got a special touch, Lauren. No horse seems able to resist you.
You've got our horses eating out of your palm already, and the children as well.
You're like a Pied Piper.
I thought we'd have to get rid of Jilly, but she's as docile as can be now.
I'm glad to be here. It's a wonderful haven.
Brendan considered Bluebird Ranch his haven, too, a place where he could be himself with an old and trusted friend. But what was she running from? There was a darkness in her eyes, some kind of suffering that made him curious. He'd ask Rick about her tonight.